90% of parenting is just thinking about when you lie down again. Hi, I am Prashant Uttekar, a learning enthusiast, and you are listening to the Relearning Podcast. And today I have my friend Alankar Mhatre, who shall help us break few myths around parenting. Alankar is a founder and lead trainer at Alankar Mhatre Learning and Solution, co-founder of Tender Wonder Preschool at Panvel, NLP practitioner, a parent coach and counselor, a children trainer, a storyteller, and also author of the wonderful book, The Power of NLP, Vidyarthi Ani Palakansathi Ek Sanjeevani. I believe that is a book in Marathi, Alankar, isn't that it?
Yes, it is currently in Marathi.
Right, so welcome to the show, Alankar.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me here, Prashant.
So this will be definitely a helpful session for me. But first things first, I really want to know, what are some few myths around parenting?
So that's a very good question, Prashant. In fact, there are so many of them. But I think I will, let me start with the one which troubled me a lot. Even I had to work very hard to get rid of this myth, which I found is very, very much there in my wife's mind, in the family members that I saw, and a lot of friends that I saw. Okay. And this is with regards to so there is this one thing which I found my wife doing. And then I realized that so many of other mothers are doing this, and precisely mothers, because mothers are the one who predominantly do the work of feeding the children.
Correct.
Okay. And I found my wife feeding them like anything. नहीं, पेट भरना चाहिए. पेट भरना चाहिए मतलब क्या? एक नहीं दो रोटी खानी चाहिए, दो नहीं तीन खानी चाहिए. नहीं इतना ही क्यों खाया? Sometimes she scolded my children, my sons. Okay. लेकिन इतना खत्म होना ही चाहिए. And I was like so behind her saying कि see, everybody's body knows how much they want. Right? Right. Even as adults, we know how much we want. Okay. That's a different story that, for kids, their systems are small, their intestines are small. So they may want food in shorter spans.
Right.
But it's a very big myth ki nahi, dekho, pet bhar ke nahi khaya, isliye abhi ek ghante baad wapas maang rahe. Right. But I tried so hard, I'll tell you, Prashant, years, saalo bita diye maine to tell this to my wife ki it is not like that. Aisa nahi ki tumhara bachcha zyada khayega matlab healthy rahega. It is more important ki wo kya kha raha hai instead of kitna kha raha hai.
Why I'm laughing?
One big thing that I struggled with. Yeah, Prashant.
The reason I am laughing is I am that person in my house.
Okay.
So you can see the kind of weight I have. And I am the one who feeds. And not only feeds a lot. And yes, you're right. Absolutely scolds if it's not eaten. But I see your point, because I also have a wife. Right. So she keeps us in line in terms of what needs to be done. But thanks for sharing that. And it's very interesting. So that's one thing we are saying, that body understands, right? Mm-hmm. So what are the other myths and there are so many that are going around.
Yes.
I also learned about a myth recently, and both of us are trainers, right? And we have this famous saying in presentation that image speaks larger, or more than 1,000 words and all that. I recently learned, when you're teaching a kid or someone like my daughter's age, avoid having many images when you're teaching them alphabets. And I was really surprised, but I realized and understood why it's saying so. Because the association should not be any other animal or a tree or something of that sort. It should be only that word or the alphabet, actually.
Kids have to be treated very differently, very creatively, very innovatively, and most importantly, very patiently.
So you've been a trainer, and I know you because we worked in a corporate and we were in the training team. What is that shift when training adults vis-a-vis training or teaching children? What is the big difference?
That's a very good question. Lot of differences and lot of similarities, right? So a lot of differences in the sense, the focus level of kids, they say ki, the focus level of kids is less compared to adults. You know, I disagree. You know, I say the focus level of kids is better than that of adults. The only thing that you have to make it interesting for them.
True.
You know, and the same with adults. The more interesting it is, you know, sometimes we get bored watching a short film of 20 minutes, right? And sometimes we watch a web series which is like 10 episodes. You know, raat ko 10 baje dekhna shuru kiya, subah 6 baje tak main dekha.
True.
So it's not about the focus and concentration. It's about the interest. But yes, of course, when you're training adults, they are a little more matured. You know, they know stuff. They can relate to things easily because they have seen the world. You know, unlike the kids. For kids, they are more into the subconscious than the conscious. So what is happening here with kids is whatever you're giving them, they are taking it and grasping it and absorbing it like a sponge. Right? Unlike adults who use a lot of logic to what is taught to them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they will try to analyze, they will try to use logic. Kids would not do that. If you want to teach a kid how to smoke cigarette, the kid will learn. Because for him, the maturity and the experience about this world that he has is very less. The exposure is very less. Right? So whatever is coming in is getting registered. And hence it is very rightly said, you know, kids are like wet cement.
Okay.
Make right impressions in the right age. Because ek bar wo cement sook gaya na, then the impression remains there for a longer time. Phir wo chini hatode ka kaam karna padega, which is not recommended.
Nice. Interesting. So very interesting. So what do you talk about in this book, especially which is based on NLP, and what are some myths that you're breaking in that book?
So this book is based on the techniques of NLP, neuro-linguistic programming.
Okay.
So there was a lot of stuff in the market with regards to NLP, a lot of people teaching NLP, right? But to my surprise, I found that there was very little or no material available in Marathi.
Interesting.
So the first thought was ki yaar NLP pe kuch karenge to Marathi mein karenge. My friend and the co-author of the book, Ashwini Falle, we both were into parent coaching, you know, and dealing with parents and children. So we thought ki we have to do, let us do something for children and students specifically.
Okay.
So what we did is we brought problems of students, you know, problems like memory issues.
Uh-huh.
Problems like bade bade jawab yaad nahi rehte, problems like badi badi spellings yaad nahi rehte, problems like ek particular subject bahut acha lagta hai lekin ek particular subject I fail to understand, problems like concentration, you know, problems like I do not have the same energy when I study, you know, that I have when I go to play. What if I have the same energy when I'm studying? So all these problems and many of those were picked up. Then because I'm a storyteller and I write stories as well. So then we created some stories around it. We also used some real life examples that we had during counseling sessions. Okay. And then in this book, we have posted problems in the form of a story. And then NLP based solutions for students. So how could you increase your memory? How could you increase your confidence level? How could you bring the same liking to a particular subject that you have for playing cricket maybe? You know? And there is a chapter for parents as well. You know, what care should parents take while dealing with the children? Because it बहुत सारे मिथ्स है ना कि नहीं नहीं सर मेरा बच्चा तो झूठ बोलता है. तो सर क्यों झूठ बोलता है? नहीं यार, खेलने के लिए बोलो तो उसको नींद नहीं आती, पढ़ाई करने के लिए बोलो तो नींद आती है. नाउ पेरेंट्स बिलीव दैट यू नो चिल्ड्रन आर ब्लफिंग, बट दिस इज नॉट, इट्स अ मिथ अगेन. व्हेन यू आर डूइंग समथिंग दैट इज इंटरेस्टिंग, यू डोंट फील स्लीपी. व्हेन यू आर डूइंग समथिंग दैट स्ट्रेसेस यू आउट, यू नेचुरली फील स्लीपी. सो पेरेंट्स हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस पार्ट ऑल्सो, एंड हेंस देयर इज अ चैप्टर फॉर पेरेंट्स एज वेल. हेंस द बुक इज नेम्ड द पावर ऑफ NLP. विद्यार्थी आणि पालकांसाठी एक संजीवनी.
व्हाट आर सम फनी स्टोरीज व्हेन यू आर कोचिंग पेरेंट्स? एनी फनी स्टोरीज देयर?
यस, फनी स्टोरीज. सो इनफैक्ट आई विल टेल यू दिस. दिस इज अ स्टोरी इनफैक्ट दैट आई हैव क्रिएटेड टू एक्सप्लेन स्टफ टू अ पेरेंट, बट दिस इज वेरी फनी एंड आई हैव टू मेक अ पॉइंट हियर. ओके. सो Parenting, what is it? You know, it is as easy as anything and it is as difficult as anything, right? Parents believe that, you know, they are scolding children or they are telling children what to do, what not to do, and that is good parenting. There is just one myth that I would like to break here. You know, पेरेंट्स बिलीव कि यार आप बच्चों को सही चीजें बताओ तो बच्चे सही रास्ते पे जाते हैं, राइट? एंड टू ब्रेक दिस मिथ आई हैव क्रिएटेड समथिंग दैट आई कॉल्ड द 80-20 रूल, राइट? नाउ 80-20 रूल यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड बिकॉज़ यू आर इन द कॉर्पोरेट, सो दैट्स अ पेरेटो प्रिंसिपल, 80-20 रूल, यू नो, समथिंग लाइक, यू नो, 80% ऑफ द वेल्थ इन द वर्ल्ड इज विद 20% ऑफ द पीपल एंड ब्ला 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 ब्ला. सो आई क्रिएटेड दिस, आई डिस्कवर्ड दैट देयर इज 80-20 रूल हियर आल्सो. मेनी पेरेंट्स बिलीव दैट आप बच्चे को सही चीजें बताओ तो बच्चा सही रास्ते पे जाएगा. And I have to break this. I have to say कि सर आप जो बताओगे ना, children will follow only 20% of it. लेकिन आप जो करके दिखाओगे ना, whatever is there in action, in your action, children will copy you and that is 80% of parenting. Children will copy you. So there is a small story which I have created to explain this. And I used this first time to coach a parent, in fact, during a counseling session. So what is parenting? Let's understand this. So there is this father and he's sitting with his child into the bedroom. The mother is out getting some food stuff and the father decides to do parenting, so-called parenting. So he starts, you know, telling his kid, you know what, son, you should never lie. Lying is a bad thing. You should always speak the truth. You know, Prabhu Ramchandra was such a big, you know, such an inspiration, such a big human being. He never lied in life. And he's giving examples from history and he's telling the child how lying is a bad thing, how telling the truth is the good thing and how you should always tell the truth and how you should not lie and blah, 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 blah. While this is happening, suddenly the doorbell rings. The child runs towards the door, leaving his father behind. Okay, picks up that small stool that he has. And he has a habit of looking through the eye hole. See, looks through the eye hole. The father follows and in a very soft voice, the father is asking the kid, "Kaun hai? Who's it?" And the kid looks into the eye hole and says, "The from the seventh floor. Oh, Sharma, tell him I'm not home." Now what is happening here? He was just telling something to his kid, that, you know, telling lie is a bad thing, you should always tell truth, blah, blah, blah. But what did he do in action? Tell him I am not home.
Exactly the opposite.
So action is teaching him to lie. Yes, exactly the opposite. Right? So now you tell me, Prashant, and parents who are listening to this, tell me, what will the kid follow? It's a very logical answer. What will he follow? The stories that you just told him or the action that you just did? Because for him, you are the idol. During the pandemic, you have to be more careful because you're more at home. The kids are observing you more. They're following you more. In fact, there's a very beautiful image that I had seen on Google. You know, this small child and father are walking and the father is walking ahead. Okay, and the child is coming from behind. You know, it's a little soiled road kind. And the father is looking behind and the father is telling his kid, you know, kid, be careful. And the kid answers, he's saying, "Father, you be careful. I am following your footsteps."
Nice.
I think this image says it all.
Yeah. What is that one thing that when you retrospect, that when you were a kid, you were taught in a certain way, and that you would say that I definitely won't do this when I'm teaching my kids, or now, of course, you are in a profession of it. So what is that one thing that, you know, that Alankar went through, but really didn't practice because it didn't make sense to him when he was literally using it in parenting or maybe in your profession as well?
So a lot of things, in fact, because parents then were different and I don't blame them. You know, it was the situation or it was the environment or it was the learning that they had from other parents. Okay, and there was no exposure as we have today, you know, YouTube channels and parent coaches and stuff like that. But there is this one thing that I really thank myself doing when I'm doing that, and I really curse my parents when I remember what happened then. Okay, so I still remember, and this might be a story with a lot of us, you know, of our age. Pitaji aa rahe pata chala. So you were like in a war fight mode. चद्दर ठीक करके रखनी है, किताबें ठीक से रखनी है, साफ सफर के हाथ में किताब लेके बैठना है, भले पढ़ो या नहीं पढ़ो, एंड ऑल दैट. इट वाज लाइक, यू नो, वो हिंदी फिल्म में होता है ना कि वो विलन इज सीन वॉकिंग एंड द हीरोइन इज लाइक, यू नो, यार आप मुझे अपनी जान बचानी, that stuff. And I always remember, I am sorry to say this, but because this is for the sake of learning for other parents and not for any other purpose, hence I'm saying this. I used to be so happy when my mother used to tell me, ki, you know, पिताजी दो दिन के लिए गांव जाने वाले. That should not be the case, ideally. वो ऐसा होना नहीं चाहिए ना. Why should you feel happy when your parent is not home? You know, but I'll tell you this, you know, there is learning everywhere. There's learning from good, there's learning from bad. I am very happy to say that when I come home, okay, and when I ring the bell, even today my kids are grown now, you know, one is will be in the 9th standard now, one in the 6th standard. Even today I feel so happy that they come, they open the door, they give me a hug, they will pick up my bag, keep it somewhere. The elder one will go bring in water for me. I feel so happy that they are not afraid ki baap ghar aa raha hai. They're happy ki baap ghar aa raha hai. They're happy ki aap aa gaye ho. So this is one big thing that always stays. And I consciously make an effort that jo mere saath hua main kisi aur ke saath nahi.
That's a good one. Though I had a different childhood though, so maybe I can't relate to it, but I know what you're saying. Well, I exactly know what you're saying. And again, it makes a lot of sense. It's always been like that, right? Traditionally, you have the breadwinner who's stricter, and traditionally, who has a breadwinner is supposed to have the reins of the house, or the brains of the house, and the heart of the house is the mother, right? So no, I absolutely get it. But things have changed. But things have changed a lot.
So, I like to add here, Prashant, sorry to stop you here.
Sure.
You know, even today, so when you say things have changed, Prashant, even today, this is my complaint, okay? So when I do parenting sessions, and I'd like to highlight this through this medium that we are doing, to the fathers especially. Even today, when I do parenting sessions, when I announce parenting sessions, some of them I do free of cost, you know, for my school parents or, you know, for parents in my fraternity. Even today, when I do parenting sessions, 90% of the people attending are mothers, not fathers.
Oh,
why? Fathers don't need parenting, is it? Fathers are like all done. They know it all. No, even today, 90% of my participants are mothers. And these mothers complain, ki aap inke pitaji se bhi thoda baat karo na.
That's very interesting.
Today I have that complaint. Yeah.
When parents come to coaching for you, what are the top 2 or top 3 things that they come to you for?
So one of the topmost thing, two topmost things I'll tell here. Ek is meri baat sunta hi nahi hai. That is one common complaint.
That's sunta a global challenge, na?
Global challenge. Sunta hi nahi hai. Theek hai? One. And two is mobile phone addiction.
Okay.
So din bhar phone pe rehta hai, in that complaint. In fact, on my YouTube channel, I have posted a video which is talking about, you know, what to do so that your child, uses less of your mobile phone. You know, how to get him rid of the mobile phone addiction. And I have developed a technique which I call giraffe technique.
Okay.
And so I would request viewers to go and watch that video. It's freely available on YouTube.
So but I'm going to add your channel in the description anyway. So I will add that.
Absolutely. Super. Because on this channel there are videos for parents as well as there are videos for corporate people like us, grooming, communication skill, and a lot of stuff. Okay. But I'll answer this in a nutshell for you. So meri baat sunta nahi. Let us come start that. Okay. Meri baat sunta nahi. Okay. Great. So once this parent come to me, she was a mother, and she says, ki sir, thoda sa mere bachcho ke saath aap kuch baat kar sakte. What happened? What's the problem? She said, sunta hi nahi meri baat. So I said, sunta hi nahi matlab kya? What is the exact problem? So she says, ki I tell him, you know, to respect elders, you know, I tell him to do this, do that, but he doesn't listen to me. Aajkal ke bachche, you know, that's a typical dialogue. Aajkal ke bachche.
True.
And that aajkal ke bachche is a dialogue that is used from generations to generations.
True.
And still with aajkal ke bachche. So I asked the lady, you know, tell me one thing that you want him to do. Let us not like, you know, phailate nahi hai.
Globalize it.
Stick to one thing.
Yeah.
One thing at a time. So tell me one thing that you want him to do. You know. So she says, ki, sorry bolna chahiye usne. Main usko kitni baar bolti hu, sorry bol. Galti ho gayi to sorry bolo. Lekin bolta hi nahi hai sorry. I said, okay, ma'am, great. See, I can solve your problem in minutes, ma'am. And she was surprised. She's like, sir, how can you solve my problem in minutes? I said, you have to cooperate. If you cooperate, I'll give you an answer in minutes. She said, yeah, please give me the answer. I'm ready to cooperate. I said, okay, ma'am, you tell me in the last 6 months, let us not go very far. Okay. In the last 6 months, how many mistakes did you make? Small, big, you know, any size, you know, as small as, you know, kisi ko daad diya, kisi ko badi awaaz mein baat kar diya, and as big as, you know, corruption kar liya, ya, you know, traffic wale ko paisa khilaya. Any small and big, how many mistakes? So she's like, oh, sir, aise kaise bata sakte ki insaan hai to galti to karega. I said, yes, ma'am, I agree, insaan hai to galti karega. I'm not blaming you for that. For the sake of your understanding, I'm asking this question. How many mistakes? So he said, sir, ki hongi, bahut sari ki hongi, why do you ask me? Tell me how many. She said, hongi 20, 25 ki hongi. I said, okay, great. Now don't tell me that mistakes, okay? Because that may be your confidential stuff. Don't tell me that mistake. 20 times you said you made mistakes in the last 6 months. I assume more, but you're saying 20, great. Okay. Out of these 20 times, how many times did you say sorry when you made a mistake? When he shouted at the istri wala, how many did you say sorry to him? Right? When you misbehave with your own parents in front of your kid, did you say sorry to your parents? How many times did you say sorry? And she's like, ekdam hota na, like the Zoom call hang ho jata na, wo wala chehra ho gaya.
Yeah.
She's like, sir, I really, I'm sorry, but ye to maine, I did not realize, you know, that is the problem, na, ma'am. When I'm telling you 80-20 rule, what is it? Children are following your action. When children will see you saying sorry to the istri wala, to the dhobi wala, respecting people, respecting your own parents, the kids will automatically start doing it. See, the kids don't understand good, bad, ugly. They understand my parents are my idols and I will follow them blindly. So, abhi na aap ek kaam karo, madam. Abhi na aap 20% ka kaam kar rahi ho, which is not working for you. Why? Because you're telling 20%. अब आप एक्शन में लाओ और अभी से आने वाले 6 महीने ना कॉन्शियसली से सॉरी व्हेन यू मेक मिस्टेक एंड इन फ्रंट ऑफ योर चिल्ड्रन एंड इफ योर चिल्ड्रन आर नॉट देयर व्हाइल गोइंग टू बेड टेल देम द स्टोरी यू नो आज मुझसे ये गलती हो गई ऑफिस में एंड आई वेंट टू दैट पर्सन एंड से सॉरी एंड दैट पर्सन फेल्ट सो नाइस यू नो एंड आवर रिलेशनशिप इंप्रूव्ड अगेन डू दैट फॉर द नेक्स्ट 6 months एंड कम बैक टू मी आई कैन
लाइक इट
टू इन राइटिंग दैट यू विल हैव चेंजेस इन योर किड I'm not saying that your kid will drastically 100%, you know, 360 degree change, but I can give it to you in writing that you will see changes and these will be long-term changes.
Very interesting.
So, in fact, Prashant, there was one case that came to me and the parent was saying, ki mera bachcha mujhse baat nahi karta. He's not free with me.
Hmm.
You know? And I gave that parent the same solution.
Same solution.
I said, aap apke bachche se baat karna shuru ko. You tell him what happened in office. You know, what good, what bad, and automatically, gradually, your child will start telling you what happened in school. That trust, that communication, the lines of communication has to open somewhere, na?
Hmm. Interesting.
So again, and what learning from the parents, yeah.
And what about the next one, which is screen time? I think that's again another thing where, you know, what has happened is, a lot of parents I know, during pandemic, they can't send the kids to play. They have answered or they have not answered any of all the questions, and the only resort they have is the screen, the mobile screen especially. So what has been that trick?
One and the first and the most important thing is when parents come to me and say, you know, mera bachcha, you know, mobile phone mein hi padha rehta, and this is pre-pandemic, I'm telling you.
Okay.
This counseling when it came to me. Okay. So there was this parent who used to walk down from Malad, अपने बच्चे को लेके आती थी यहाँ पे पनवेल में for the counseling session, you know, बहुत बिचारी hard work कर रही
थी for
that sake, क्योंकि तब तब Zoom boom वो सब नहीं था, this was quite a years back, way before the pandemic, right? And I'll tell you this case first and then I'll tell you the solution. So I just want to highlight this because she came to me and then she had a lot of problems. You know? She had two daughters and she used to bring her elder daughter to me. And our relationship is not good, and you know, daughter doesn't listen to me, and she is only you know, busy with her mobile phone, right? Now this is very interesting. and very alarming as well, Prashant. I would like to highlight this. Now, when I spoke to the lady and her daughter, I took a call that I will not get this child rid of her mobile phone addiction. This is, you know, it might surprise you when I'm saying this. She had come to me for that reason. Mm. And I took a call, I will not get her rid of mobile phone addiction. Now, see what was happening here. When I spoke after 2-3 sessions, when I spoke to that girl also, I discovered that the father was not home. The mother was not home. The child is home with the younger sister the whole day,
uh-huh.
right? There is one nokrani that comes, a kamwali bhai that comes, a maid, okay? And she doesn't like the maid because okay. according to her, the maid is a bad woman, which her parents are not ready to believe. She tried hard telling the parents.
Okay.
Now the only source that she has is the mobile phone. अगर मैं वो निकाल लू ना उसके हाथ से प्रशांत, she will go into depression.
Hmm.
She has nothing. The only source she has at home is the mobile phone. कोई बात करने के लिए नहीं है, कोई friend नहीं है, कोई 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 कुछ नहीं है. It is only the mobile phone. And I took that call very consciously that ma'am, at least now I will not get her rid of the mobile phone till the time you develop communication with your child. And I work on the parent and not the child. Right? Now, the same lady has another child, okay, which is a younger one. I'm not naming the lady because this is just for the sake of our learning and not to defame anybody. But I'll tell you how worse this was. She one day comes to me and says, "Ki, sir, you know, I have another problem now. Can you help me?" So what is the problem? He said, "Meri nokrani jo hai na, wo kaam chhod ke ja rahi hai." So I said, is that a problem? I mean, find another one. I know, you know, getting maids is difficult, but you know, find another one first and then ask her to leave. She, no, sir, I cannot do that. And then keep her. I cannot keep her because she's asking for double the money. I said, I'm not understanding your problem. If she's asking for double the money, then change her. Now, I cannot change. I said, why can't you change her? What's the big problem? She says, my younger one is so used to her and that she also knows. She's so used to her. If I am not home for like 14 days, 15 days when I'm on my business tours, she has no problem. But if the maid is not home on time, even for an hour, you know, she loses her temper. She wants the maid. And the maid knows this. Now the maid is blackmailing me. Ek toh meri pagar badao, nahi toh main chhod ke jaati hu. Aap bolo kya karna hai. It is such a bad situation, Prashant,
that
children are getting so used to the maid and not the parents. It is the fault. The only reason for this is you are not giving adequate time. You want to earn money, I understand. Yeah, everybody wants to money, but badle mein kya de rahe ho? What are you giving in return? What should be the priority? If the mother is not home, koi fark nahi padta. If the kamwali is not home, तो बच्ची दिन भर रो रही है देन व्हाट वेयर आर वी गोइंग एज पेरेंट्स देन व्हाई वुड नॉट द एल्डर वन गेट मोबाइल फोन एडिक्टेड बिकॉज़ शी हैज नोबडी एटलीस्ट द यंगर वन यू नो लव्स द कामवाली भाई द एल्डर वन नोज शी डजंट इवन लाइक हर नाउ शी इज स्टेइंग एट अ होम वेयर नोबडी इज देयर वन पर्सन इज देयर हुम शी डजंट लाइक हुम नोज इज मैनिपुलेटिंग माय यंगर सिस्टर बट आई कांट डू एनीथिंग अबाउट इट राइट Now, what to do here? Okay. So, what does this giraffe technique say? So, I have developed this and I am just reading it out for you and I'll explain this to you in a very nutshell maybe. Okay. So, when I say giraffe, you know, the G stands for give quality, fun and exciting time.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not saying give more time. I'm not at all saying give more time. I am saying whatever time you are giving, make that time quality time. I'll give you an example. Okay. One father came to me saying, ki, sir, ye hai, waisa hai, aisa hai. You know, so family life kuch meri bachi nahi hai isse. Ye mera company ne mere ko pura nichod ke rakh diya hai. I said, okay, sir. मेरे बच्चे सर थोड़े दिनों में मेरे को चाचा बुलाएंगे. आई सर ओके सर, सो व्हाट टू डू देन, लीव जॉब? नो सर, हाउ कैन आई लीव जॉब? सर देन गिव टाइम टू योर चाइल्ड. नहीं सर, कैसे टाइम दूं, एक ही संडे मिलता है. आई सेड सर आप संडे को क्या करते, थोड़ा बताओगे? सर देखिए सैटरडे नाइट मेरी होती है तो मैं दारू लेके बैठता हूँ, है ना, तो मैं मन भर के पीता हूँ सैटरडे को. फिर मैं जो है ना संडे को लेट उठता हूँ, है ना, और फिर संडे को लेट उठने के बाद फिर मैं सीधा खाना खाने के लिए उठता हूँ. फिर मैं खाना खाता हूँ, फिर दोपहर का थोड़ा सा मैं टीवी देखता हूँ, है ना, फिर उसके बाद मैं फिर से थोड़ा सो जाता हूँ. तब तक सर रात हो जाती है, फिर मैं खाना खाता हूँ, फिर दूसरा दिन है मंडे. ऐसे सर एक संडे ऐसा बिताओ ना कि रात को मत पियो, सुबह जल्दी उठो क्योंकि हैंगओवर नहीं होगा तो जल्दी उठोगे, अपने बच्चों के लिए अपने हाथों से कुछ पकाओ, है ना, फिर उनको उठाओ, बोलो आज डैडी घर पे, आज डैडी ने आपके लिए कुछ बनाया है. दोपहर का टाइम पहले से प्लान कर लो, टेक देम टू द पार्क विद योर वाइफ, यू एंड योर वाइफ सिट एंड डिस्कस फैमिली मैटर्स, द किड्स विल प्ले इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. यार थोड़ा मैं नहीं बोल रहा हूँ कि पूरा वीक बच्चे के साथ रहो, बट यार जब एक संडे मिलता है उसमें से चार घंटे तो क्वालिटी टाइम इज अ प्रॉब्लम. एंड आई एम टेलिंग यू, आपके बच्चे बड़े अंडरस्टैंडिंग होते हैं, कितने अच्छे कितने बुरे हो, वो बड़े अंडरस्टैंडिंग होते हो. आप उनको एक संडे ठीक से दो ना प्रशांत, वो पूरा हफ्ता उस राह में बिता लेंगे कि एक और संडे आने वाला है. सो फर्स्ट जी इज गिव क्वालिटी फन एंड एक्साइटिंग टाइम. सेकेंड आई इज इंडिविजुअल अटेंशन इज मस्ट, राइट. देन कम्स टू आर विच इज रिस्पॉन्ड डोंट रिएक्ट. मेनी टाइम्स वी रिएक्ट, डांट दिया, बोल दिया, अरे समझ में नहीं आता यार मैं ऑफिस का काम कर रहा हूँ बीच बीच में. नहीं यार, respond. And there's another video that is there on my YouTube channel which talks about what to do to respond. Then comes the A, appreciate, appreciate, appreciate. Okay, there is a myth again, you know, and it's a myth where, you know, we believe that catch your children doing the wrong thing. बच्चों पे ध्यान रखो, क्या क्या गलतियां कर रहा है पकड़ो और उसको सुधारो, ठीक है. मैं ना थोड़ा सा मॉडर्न जमाने का बाप हूं, मैं बोलता हूं कैच योर चिल्ड्रन डूइंग द राइट थिंग एंड अप्रिशिएट. सो द ए गोज फॉर अप्रिशिएट. देन अनदर ए गोज फॉर अलर्टनेस इज रिक्वायर्ड. यू हैव टू बी अलर्ट कि ठीक है आपका बच्चा स्क्रीन टाइम बढ़ गया है, यू नो नाउअडेज ऑनलाइन क्लासेस ऑल दैट, बट देन यू हैव टू बी अलर्ट कि क्या देख रहा है एग्जैक्टली. देन फाइंड योर सेल्फ इन देयर वर्ल्ड. चिल्ड्रन हैव अ डिफरेंट वर्ल्ड. Their world is, you know, बाप की पीठ पे बैठेंगे और घोड़ा घोड़ा खेलेंगे. That is their world. Then follow the 80-20 rule, which we already discussed. Children will follow your actions 80%. Then E is E time to G time. I understand you cannot take your children to the parks to show them greenery. G time is the green time. ठीक है, बट एक छोटी सी चीज करो यार, आपके घर में ना एक गमला लगाओ, उसमें एक छोटा सा सीड डालो. पर बच्चों को बोलो रोज ऑब्जर्व करने, बोलो देखो अभी इसमें से एक पत्ता आ गया. इफ यू गिव देम द राइट थिंग्स टू डू, दे विल गो लेस टुवर्ड्स द मोबाइल स्क्रीन. इफ दे हैव मोर पेरेंट टाइम, दे विल स्पेंड लेस स्क्रीन टाइम. एंड लास्ट बट नॉट द लीस्ट, सो दिस इज जिराफ्स विद द एस, स्क्रीन टाइम टू बी लिमिटेड. डिसाइड द स्क्रीन टाइम एज अ फैमिली. द मिस्टेक दैट पेरेंट्स मेक हियर इज दे डिसाइड स्क्रीन टाइम फॉर द चाइल्ड एंड नॉट फॉर देमसेल्व्स. अगेन द 80-20 रूल फॉलोज ना, द चाइल्ड विल कॉपी यू. अरे आप तो, और आजकल के बच्चे तो बोल देते हैं मुंह पे, अरे आप तो दिन भर वेब सीरीज देख रहे थे और मुझे चिल्ला रहे हो, राइट. तो दिस इज द जिराफ्स टेक्निक इन अ नटशेल. और मैं बोल रहा हूँ इसमें से यार तीन चार चीजें भी करना शुरू करो तो एटलीस्ट आपके बच्चे जो 7 घंटा मोबाइल फोन पे है, एटलीस्ट 5 घंटा 4 घंटे पे आ जाएंगे. दैट इज माई प्रॉमिस टू डू, दैट्स फॉर श्योर.
नो सुपर्ब एंड थैंक्स अगेन अलंकार. ओके बिफोर वी रैप अप, anything that you want to convey to the children or their parents?
Yes, one thing that I want to through this medium, Prashant, is so I believe that stories are very powerful. Okay, and right. There is a lot of impression that happens in our personality with the help of stories. मतलब हमारी दादा दादी कहानियाँ सुनाए करते थे. So stories are very powerful. Even when we are doing counseling, you know, NLP based coaching. We use a lot of metaphors, a lot of stories, a lot of examples. So what I'm doing is from the 12th of this month, next month, 12th right. of June, I'm starting storytelling session for children aged 9 years to 15 years.
Nice.
Okay. The sessions, 9 years to 15 years. The session will start with a 10-15 minute meditation. then I'll be telling them a story, and these will not be like those lion and the mouse and all those stuff. These will be like really handpicked stories that work on the subconscious mind, right? And then I will not tell them the moral of the story. They will tell me what they learned, because I don't want to confine them to one thought that is my thought. I want them to be creative, to be imaginative. And then I may give them an activity based on the story. So, for example, I told them a story about confidence building. And then I give them an activity saying, now, you know, activity for this week is you have to talk to somebody whom you fear to talk. Maybe your teacher, maybe the principal of the school, maybe your father, maybe the neighbor. So that builds confidence in action as well. So I'm starting storytelling sessions from the 12th right. of June. Parents who want to connect can please connect. The closing line that I wanted to add is, you know, everybody wants good children, right? Right. And the formula to have good children is become good parents.
Superb. And thank you so much, Alankar. You've been quite insightful. A couple of things that I have picked, and I'm sure many listeners who are listening to you for the first time at least have picked their own lessons or things to do. So thank you so much for doing this, man, and I really wish you well and good luck with everything that you're doing.
My pleasure, Prashant. I want to thank you for having me here, for giving me the opportunity. I want to thank our listeners who are listening to us now. Maybe after the recording, they will listen to us. So I want to thank them in advance for listening to the podcast, and stay in touch, stay confident, and be good parents.
All right. Bye.
Bye-bye. Take care.